Iraq, it should be. There's a plan to destroy, reconstruct Iraq, Afghanistan, but not urban America. Talk about 100,000 vacant homes of abandoned lots. If that were planned, commit to use stimulus money to reconstruct destroyed homes based upon bank misbehavior, we'd have to have landscapers and we replace the woods and underpanes and create a need for supplies, and roofers and replaces and the like. There is no plan to reconstruct urban America. The other issue, of course, is transportation. Many Republican governments refuse to accept the fast transit money because it connects the inner city with where the jobs are. So if Wallace was not allowed to block access to the education door, they must not be allowed to block the transportation doors to access to jobs, education, healthcare, and a base for education. It seemed that we bail out Wall Street, not linked to lending or reinvestment. So Wall Street is awash in capital and poverty is expanding on the ground. American workers in trouble in part because we're outsourcing jobs to cheap labor markets and insourcing products from cheap labor markets into our country. We need a real redirection.
And as pointed out, helping the workers helps the banks do more business.
It does. I mean, there was the Glass-Steagall Act, which means you cannot lend and invest on the same roof. Banks are trust between investing, even high risk, over lending. That's what they chose to do. So there's a collapse of the American economy, and they got bailed out without any penalty, not linked to lending. And of course, the banks got the big bailout, the richest Americans, the excessive worst tax cut. That tax amounted to more than all state budget deficits combined. And so the rich have gotten much richer. We had 300 billionaires 10 years ago, now we have 1,000 billionaires. On the other hand, we have poverty at 30% to 50% in two of the zones in our country.
Have you seen achievements in 40 years that make you pleased, or are you more concerned about the work that needs to be done?
Well, I'm highly anxious. I'm anxious to the fact that the president was able to stop the hemorrhaging for 800,000 jobs a month, and that was a big deal. He fought for a health plan that got derailed in a bloody confrontation. People fought to destroy him and destroy the health care plan for political gain. The result is, because we don't have the public option, health care fees are still rising, and more Americans are without health insurance. We keep expending monies in Iraq and Afghanistan, $2 billion a week. Libya, $10 million a day. These huge outlays of money for wars and for the wealthy, and the American worker is suffering because of that. I am rather convinced that we now need a target plan to reinvest in America. One of the features about the book is that you like we give away $500,000 in scholarships tonight. We've given away about $3.5 million in scholarships the last 7 years tonight. Giving away $500,000 in scholarships. And we're honoring Judge Greg Matthews, who we met when he was a jail inmate. And he got out, got his GED, never got deployed, went to college and law school. The direct experience, he's now TV Judge Matthews. He's gone from jail to judgeship at Red Trinity. The brilliant Evans, a football player, has given away to $1 million in scholarships. He told 100 kids if they would do well, if they would attend school and keep their grades, he would give them a $10,000 scholarship. The brilliant Evans, he's given away $1 million in college scholarships. And that should be a shout to other athletes who make that kind of money, even if you invest. Students can give more and more taxes back to the government.
That's a real hero.
He's a real hero. Really never from the real chance.
Thank you for your time. It's good to see you again.